Kannika Suteerattanapirom from the Department of Archaeology at Silpakorn University. Dr Kannika received her MA in the History of Architecture and a PhD in Historical Archaeology at Silpakorn University, and she was a research fellow at the East West Center in the University of Hawaii in Manoa. Over the last 20 years, Dr Kannika has conducted many, many archaeological investigations in Bangkok, including the Ratchathon School area, the Thonburi train station, the city wall in the Bangkok area, Somerset Park, and Wachira Hospital. She has an upcoming publication in the Thammasat Review about the urban archaeology in Bangkok. And so we look forward to hearing about the many things beneath our feet. Dr Kannika.
The overall observation of archaeology in Bangkok. As you know, after the Uthaya Kingdom, ancient capital city was defeated and lost its independence in 1767. Thus, the anti-social coup began the independence of the kingdom in the same year. Name of this kingdom is Thonburi, or we know as Bangkok. This is the map of Bangkok in the 18th century. The old map, or the old map of the Bangkok in 18th century or in the Uthaya period. And this one, this is the old map also. This one, this is a map of Thonburi drawn by the Burmese who entered during the time of Thonburi, its capital. And this one, this is the only map of Thonburi city we have. And this, I think this map is very important. You know, Thonburi city was the latest and the new capital because the former capital after Uthaya was so damaged. The king constructed his palace in the area in the west bank of Jamaya River in here. And the king Baksin brought the royal family of Uthaya kingdom to Thonburi. The map showing you the Thonburi city, and this is the main river, the Jamaya River. And this place is the Thonburi city. The number one is the royal palace of King Baksin. And the number eight, this one is like a house of elephants, elephants house, and we'll talk about this later. Next, I would like to show you the map of the development of the city. When the King Rama I commanded the removal of the capital Thonburi on the west bank of the river to the east bank, new capital name Ratanakosin City, or we know as Bangkok. Ratanakosin City took 10 years to complete. The king and his soldier was recruited for the construction of the two important palace. In here, the Glad Palace. And the next one we call Bowasatan Mokon Palace, or sometimes we call French Palace. And the opposite one here we call Bowasatan Pimo Palace. And this palace is very important. And you know, however, in the range of King Rama I, King Rama IV, they built a new city mall in here. But anyway, no city wall was built in that time. But the new eight fortress built around the new city. Then Bangkok have erupted from an agricultural community sitting along the main river. Archaeologists know what happened in the past by using the historical map, the old picture, historical record. And this is the example of the old picture in Bangkok and the old map. And archaeologists use this evidence to predict and prove what the construction underneath our feet. Nowadays, Bangkok has been changed rapidly through the urban expansion and the infrastructure developments. Through times, the city has transformed into a metropolis as seen today. This transformation has continued for at least 600 years since the time of Ayutthaya. However, we often see in the news about the ancient ruins being accidentally found underground the city around the world, same as in Bangkok. For example, around 5 years ago in Thonburi area near the Sivilas Hospital in the west bank of Tapia River, we found this thing. This is like a ruin, and it's like an ancient monument, and we found something like a Chinese ceramic and the fragment of the pottery. Yeah. I think that was very a surprising discovery. And last year, the Fine Art Department studied and found that the ruin used to be a construction of the ancient bridge of Ratanakos in the city. Then we know what the thing are underneath. This is the area of accidentally found archaeological evidence underground the city. We always found something like this one. Or like fragment of the pottery and Chinese ceramics. And this one is coins and glass bottle. Yeah. And sometimes we found something like human bone. And such as in the 1992, during the digging the Chetupon Road in here for electricity system, human skull was discovered. And actually, I never see by myself before. I read it from the newspaper. Such as in 1999, Fine Art Department find the cornerboard and ceramic in the National Theatre area. National Theatre area is near Senangu. It's near the Grand Palace. And we found this thing why they will work on improving this area. That's, you know, that's all I show you. This is a part of the story of archaeology in Bangkok. And today, I would like to show you this one. This one is the at the top of my speaking. Archaeological excavation project has been carried out over 20 sites in Bangkok. You can see the location of all projects on this map. The red and the blue one, the blue spot, it shows the location of the excavation site. But the blue one showing the last excavation project working in about the last 3 years. Now, I am gathering the information and knowledge from each site from excavation report. And I found that the project can be classified into type according to the characteristic of the work. The first, I think, archaeological work relating to building construction and surrounding area, which mainly connection to the highways project as well as the community project. And the second, I think, the work related to the public utility with coming to the government sector. And today, nowadays, excavation in Bangkok has started systematically in the past over 20 years. And I would like to show you the five key sites. All the five key sites will be the represent of situation, archaeology work in Bangkok, and all five sites I show you are in the center of the ancient city, or we call it the Nakhon City. The first one, in Thammasat University complex. In 1994, the first systematic excavation project carried out along the Jobia riverside in Thammasat University complex in Thapatan. This work began with Thammasat University has a project to improve the library building and the parking area. And after times, you know, in 2001, academics focus on urban archaeology in Bangkok appeared from the seminar for the first time. I think on that time, I show you the layout of the construction of library building. It's located in the Zambia River here, and this is the construction of the library. The excavation conducted by he is the lecturer in Thammasat University at the time, and with archaeology for fine art department, along with Moradoglo company. I can say it was regarded as an advancement of urban archaeology in Thailand. It was the first glass excavation in urban area. From historical record, indicated this area used to be the Bobowasatan Mongkol Palace or Fourth Palace. The palace built in the reign of King Rama I in 18th century with Thai traditional style, along with the Grand Palace. The Fourth Palace or the Crown Palace is mean the house of who appointed by the king, usually son or brother of the king who bear the title the second king. After excavation done, the ruins of ancient Bangkok city wall and the ministry building were revealed. Now, some remains of ancient city wall can be found inside the Thammasat University. There was also a conservation of the discovery ancient remains. Unfortunately, I didn't have pictures of the excavation at that time because I think at that time they didn't use the digital camera like today. Next, I'd like to show you the another key site in Museum Siam. This area used to be Ministry of Commerce in the range of King Rama VI. After that, in 2007, they improved the whole of this area to be Museum Siam. And the area was lucky enough to be excavated, especially in the front of the building. This yellow one, this yellow building was Ministry of Commerce Office, or sometimes they call it Thadien Ministry, because its location in the area of the Thadien. The building of ministry and also commercial building in the range of King Rama VI create the opportunity for further development. King's opportunity for King visionary idea led to the building of public utility and public place according to the European countries. Then, in 2007, this area transformed to Museum Siam. According to the excavation in front of this building, we found evidence of the palace, four palace we found. And also we found a large number of artifacts, like pottery, Chinese ceramic, and European ceramics, and terracotta sculpture. Anyway, you know, pottery is the most substantial category of archaeology material that we uncover and analyze. And their parents were not their royal residence, but also used as the place to conduct activity of the owner. For example, the discovery of the pearl ornament production in the palace. Is it the pearl? The discovery of the pearl ornament in palace of those who work for the department of the pearl inlay. And from the excavation, the four palaces have appeared before the construction of Western style ministry. And then now is in the place we know as Museum Siam. This is the development of the land use of this area. Anyway, the big phenomenon was the immersion of MRT project. The first subway transportation was opened in Soviet official colony on 2004. And 18 days from the colony line to the Ratanakosin city, the first line with the route passing the Ratanakosin area was the blue line. The blue line is from the MRT along this way to the Tonbri area. So there is a Namchai MRT station in the future. This Namchai MRT station in front of the main entrance of Museum Siam, which is already considered the gateway of visitors to explore the historical site in the old town area. The Siam Chai subway station is decorated with elements of the Thai traditional art to relate to the elaborate structure of neighboring site, as including the Grand Palace and Wat Pho or Pho Temple. I hope they will reconsider to use the knowledge from excavation to redesign the identity of this station again. And this one is an example of the result of urban excavation in Central Park of Thailand. This is the Chevengung Road. Chevengung Road, or we know as the new road of the first international road in Bangkok. This road will be MRT station. Name of this station is Wang Bulapa. We found the foundation of commercial building. The commercial building is like a symbol, it's like a symbolic symbol of the further development in the colonial occupation period. And the next one. By the times of the excavation at the Museum Siam, there was an archaeological excavation nearby at Rajini School. The reason of this work was the school planned to extract it a new building. The area of the school was regarded as a considerable historical area, so study was conducted. Rajini School, or we call the Queen School, was founded in 1904 in the reign of King Mahmud's fifth period. Since then, the school's administration has been managed by several members of the royal family, as well as the wives of Thai noblemen. From excavation uncovered the foundation of the former Ministry of Education building in the reign of King Mahmud V, and we found art and antique with reflection that uses in the area, focusing on something like European ceramic, some European porcelain. And this one is from England, Scotland, and Belgium. There were the evidence that confirmed the social pattern associated with the greater society and notions at that time. Another site, in October 2007, while digging at the area of the back of the Kloksa district office, was preparing for the new building construction. A large number of timbers were found while preparing this construction. It was very important because it used to be the location of Bom Ajamit Fort. Bom Ajamit Fort. Which was construction, the fastest in the range of King Rama the fourth, and considered to have been the greatest fort of the Thonburi area. Now you can see the monument of the fortress is here. On Ajamit Fortress, you can see the old layout of this fort. It's like a star fort. But now you can see the route like this. The fortress from the era of King Rama IV have a more complicated construction technique. Both in terms of construction techniques and expansion, this fortress is stronger than another things that was built before. This may be related to the political situation at that time, with the threats of foreign invasion. The depth from the column surface to the bottom brick layer in 2 meters. And I think the best key site of urban archaeology in Bangkok is here, in Silila Biak Maharashkarun Hospital. In Silila Biak Maharashkarun Hospital is operated by the Faculty of Medicine, Silila's Hospital of Mahidol University. It is located in Bangkok of the west bank of the Zambia River. The Silila Hospital was transferred a piece of land for state railway station. Following from the board resolutions in 2003 and finally on 2010. From here, from train station, and then Silila here. From historical record indicated, it was located in the area of Bowasatan Pimuk Palace, or we can call the Ria Palace, and used to be the Thonburi runway station in the range of King Rama V. And now see last hospital renovated the whole area to build a new hospital here. The excavation at the site of Silila in 2008 was another source of an intriguing work. Sadly, the excavation started after the construction company has already dug to prepare the construction all over the area. This is the picture. This is the picture show you about the preparing area to build the new building. And this one, this is the train station office. While the digging underground of the city, we found underground in the Silila's hospital, they found much timbers. The wood itself have a large shape, more than 100 woods. So it is believed to be a timber used to create temporary camping site of Thonburi city during the Thonburi period. We know that because the legend tell us. The work at that time was at like an urgent rescue, with planning and operating along with the construction. The result of the survey found artifacts such as the pitch of the human skeletons, human bone, elephant bones, and like a Thonburi map showing the elephant house. And we also found domestically producted pottery, Chinese ceramic, and roof tiles to the area. All of this evidence proved this area used to be the place of human settlement before. And I show you some local pottery we found in this area. Actually, we always found this type of pottery every site in Bangkok, not just in Bangkok, in Ayutthaya, also in Supanburi, and along the Javaya River, and the central area in Thailand, we also found this type of pottery. And this pottery used for everyday life. And it's dated back around the late Ayutthaya period in 18th century to the Bangkok period. And from the ancient map in 1887 shows the map and the layout of the palace in the red line. This is the Mongolstan Pimun Palace. And in the Google map, we can see this area is changed and transformed to be the hospital. And this area we call Wanglang District. And however, from this map, we can follow this map to predict and find the tracks of the ancient palace. This is why archaeologists know where should they excavate it. And I would like to talk about this place, this area. And we excavation this area. And you can see this one is like a false case. We excavated in this area on the back of the office train station building. This was the first test of the palace, which was located in the northeast corner of the palace. And I think it might be a part of the ancient Tongari city wall before. This is my opinion. This is part of the first test of the palace. And the first test had never been raised in the history before. It was found that under the last deep row, sand was used with the same site as selected from other area for improving the area before the pedestal with brick was constructed. And now, the train station office was renovated and transformed to be the Silila Pimokstan Museum. This museum is the newest museum in Silila Hospital. On the back of this building, they conserve this remain and set up it to the open side. And this area is used to be the Tongari railway station, so train was another type of transportation first appeared in the reign of King Rama V. Not only trains were convenient for traveling along this time, they could also lead to the progress of the country. The station is the main departure point of the train to the south and west of Thailand, along the route of the World War II, this runway. During the Second World War, the station became a strategic quarry important at the Japanese base of the operation for supplying the construction of the Burma runway. But anyway, it was damaged by repeated bombing in 1994 to 1995. This is the artifacts about the war we found. During the Second World War too, the Second World War, bombing destroyed many facilities, and we found the three bombs. But anyway, archaeologists cannot bring this artifact to analyze this more, and we call police and we call the soldier instead. Moreover, during the dark, the boats were completely covered. It was assumed that after this boat stopped in this area, some part of the boat was burned. The boat was laid on the logs, and the logs is used to support the boat. Yeah, this is really excavation. After the archaeological work, Faculty of Hospital in Silpakorn turn the gather the information, knowledge, and all evidence into the exhibition at Silpakorn Thailand Museum, the palace, the fortress, together with the board work, also conserved and exhibited. Now, board is showing in the museum. So, to summarize the main point of my talk, the current situation of Bangkok, of archaeology in Bangkok, I think, first, archaeological project at various sites in Bangkok related to infrastructure construction or fundamental utility system, and all of the archaeological excavation were considered as surveys archaeology or surveys of archaeological evidence before the site were destroyed. And I think the cost of merchants of the work in Bangkok arose from the demands of collect evidence and to relieve impact of construction as well as area adjustment. And no excavation was determined by the area and object for in-depth study. Very little is known about archaeology in Bangkok on the local and regional context, and some artifacts were excavated when digging during the construction repairing period. And I think, personally, Bangkok is one of the world's metropolis. It's comprised of modern building of old ruins of traditional building. I think archaeology should be taken consideration for Bangkok's property development plan. And archaeology in Bangkok deals with living city and people who live in, and it should involve people in the urban society. And well, that is for me. And thank you very much.
Dr. Kannika, always reminded when we do archaeology in urban environments, we almost always dig up some sort of explosives, and it's always fun with having to tussle with the police over who owns the archaeological explosives. Now, are there any questions for Dr. Kannika?
Hi, thank you very much. That was a very good presentation. I'm just curious from a historic perspective versus a commercial perspective, when a construction company is digging and you just need to drive around and they're everywhere, what is the procedure when they actually uncover something? Are they required by law to call and say we've uncovered something, or do they just continue to dig?
Thank you very much for the question. I think the fire department, yeah, Dr. Pontam can can answer this question better than me, because I am in an academy, in university. And anyways, but I think when the contact company dig in the area, we don't have like a rule, law, like something. We don't have law. Yeah, that's why I have to say that archaeology should be taken consideration of Bangkok property of development plan.
Okay. As a follow-up question then, what were the, from the five sites you just described, what was the trigger that got the archaeological department involved? Something had to trigger your involvement in it, so how did that come about?
Because, example, in this one, yeah. We know that because the fire department found this situation and called to the archaeology department that, and then begin the study in this site.
It was very interesting when you showed that map of Tongri, and that was the first one. What is the history in Thailand, or in Bangkok, or Kuntep, in map making and map recording. Was it just casual and disciplined, or was there actually people who specialize in maintaining maps of the city?
You mean the Thonburi city map, right?
Well, even for Bangkok, too, on this side. I mean, was there a major discipline, or was it just haphazard or accidental in the map recording and retention?
Yeah, actually, I'm interested in to study the ancient map too. Just like, for example, in this map, studied by Dr. Sunet from Chulalongkorn University, then and he write the article. Then I know that. But another one like something like this, we know that from the Chulalongkorn Karnataka. I think the architecture department in Silpakorn University have studied and capturing and collect the collection of the map. Yeah, I think he can.
Well, I heard you say terracotta, did you? And I thought perhaps you should have said pottery pieces, because, you know, terracotta is a term, terracotta, but like ceramics is another term. So I thought, why? Thank you.
Yeah, thank you very much for the question. I'm actually more for that. I didn't show you the terracotta sculpture that we found. The scholar capture we found is something like a sculpture, like something like a doll, a small doll, something like that, underground the city. Yeah, it's something like that we found, but not that much. We found the terracotta sculpture in the museum Siam, only in the museum Siam.
Right. Well, because paint clay can be different according to the clay and temperature. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you. Terracotta for me, I mean, it's something like a doll, small doll, but earthenware. In terracotta and earthenware, stoneware, and porcelain. Earthenware is I mean something like a pottery. Pottery like the local pottery. This one is a fragment of the pottery, or we call chode.
So I think it might be just a difference in terminology.
When something is found in the construction site, and you guys come in and say, stop, we want to excavate it. Who is paying for the damage to the construction site? Normally, a contractor has a time limit. They have to finish within a certain period, and now there is a delay. Who is paying for the delay? I mean, I have another remark. I know when the Covard road was built by the Americans, and they found fossils. And the management said, shut up, and bulldozed everything away, that archaeologists couldn't see anything, and that there was no delay. But I mean, I think here in Bangkok, to hush up is not so easy. But so my question is, who pays for that?
The owner project, pray for that. It's same as in America case study. Yeah, something like a Siam hospital, in same Siam, Rajini, yeah. The owner pay for that, all that.
Thank you, Dr. Kannika.